So what is freeze drying? It is also called lyophilization. It is a successful process of liquid separation from product in a frozen state achieved by sublimation under vacuum. Okay, what is meaning of this? A food product, it is frozen first, then vacuum pump is attached. And because of vacuum, what will happen? Whatever ice is there, it will directly sublimate in vapor, and the final product, it will be moisture free. Okay, now there are two types of drying. One is drying by heating. Okay, it can be done with the help of solar as well. And second one is freeze drying. Now there are lot of disadvantages of drying with the help of heating. It changes the shape and size of the product. Then the taste of the product also changes because of heating of the product. And also nutrients are lost. To prevent that, this freeze drying method is used. Drying by heating, because of that, what happens? There is loss of flavor and food value. Food is frozen. So what is freeze drying? That we will see. Food is frozen and kept at a temperature much below triple point of water in a vacuum chamber. The ice in the food sublimates, rendering the food almost dry. Then the food is stored in airtight vessel or packaging, and its life is 25 to 30 years. Now obviously you can understand that this process is very costly, because we are able to preserve the food for 25 to 30 years. Then how to use this food? If this food is mixed with water, it regains nearly original fresh condition. So just what you have to do, we have to use the freeze drying machine where the food is frozen and it is kept below the triple point. Then vacuum is turned on. Because of that, ice will be sublimated, and then we have to store the food in the airtight containers. Okay, then how to use that? We have to just mix the water and then you can consume the food. Such freeze dry foods can be stored in airtight dry containers for months without refrigeration. It is costly, therefore it is used by Navy, military, people working on ships and in space. So we will see a small video over here.
Freeze drying, or lyophilization, is a complete dehydration process designed to allow food to retain nutrition for a very long time. Often described as suspended animation for food, freeze drying is used to make easily storable food for astronauts, soldiers, and other people. It is also used to store pharmaceuticals, biological samples, and even flowers. Freeze drying is based on completely removing water from food, because water causes food to spoil faster. The water in food sustains bacteria and microorganisms that can spoil the food faster and release odors. Removing water from food significantly reduces its weight. Many foods are made up of significant amounts of water, and some foods are composed of up to 90% water. Because of this, dehydration makes the food lighter and easier for one person to carry. NASA utilized freeze-drying technology to process food for cramped space quarters during the Apollo missions. Because the microgravity environment of space requires quick food preparation, freeze-drying has been the best way to store food for space missions ever since. Freeze-drying is different from dehydration. Dehydration involves evaporating water through applied heat to a substance. However, the evaporation procedure does not get rid of all the water, and the heat required to evaporate the water significantly changes the shape and composition of the food. Freeze drying is based on drying a substance without applying the heat of evaporation. This is done through sublimation, a phase change from solid to gas directly. Phase changes are dependent on temperature and pressure. A freeze drying machine uses refrigerated coils to freeze the material solid, which separates the water from the rest of the substance on a molecular level. Then, a vacuum lowers the pressure inside the container with the material to below 0.6 atmospheres. The machine then applies a small amount of heat, which does not alter the substance greatly, but is enough to sublimate the water completely to water vapor. The vapor then leaves the container. The material is packaged in a moisture-free container and is ready to store. When consumed, a bit of hot water is added to the material to revitalize it to its original state.
Okay, so this type of, here you can see some arrangement. The cylinder is there, which is, here you can see it is in horizontal position, and this type of freezer, if you see, it is called freeze dryer. Okay, and it is available for home application also, but it is very costly. You can visit this website harvestright.com. Okay, they provide freeze drying for home application, where here you can see outside vacuum pump has been provided, and this is the freeze dryer. Okay, so if you see like this construction, like this circular gate is there. Okay, basically this is freeze drying. Next, we will see the application of refrigeration in chemical and process industries. Okay, so we have started with this one. I'll go to the classification. Okay, we have seen food processing, preservation, and distribution. Now we will see chemical and process industries. After that, we will see special applications. So I will go to the chemical and process industries now. Application of refrigeration. Okay, so first application is separation and liquefaction of gases. So in petrochemical plant, temperature as low as minus 150 degrees Celsius with refrigeration capacity as high as 10,000 TR are used for separation of gases by fractional distillation. So basically, using the distillation process, after that condensation is required. Okay, so there refrigeration is required. And mostly propane is used as refrigerant. Then solidification of solute. One of the processes of separation of a substance or pollutant or impurity from liquid mixture is by its solidification at low temperature. So suppose there is a liquid and in that liquid some impurity is there or some other substance is there that needs to be separated. That can be done by solidification. Okay, so that is also an application of refrigeration. Here one example is given. Lubricating oil is de-waxed in petroleum industry by cooling it below minus 25 degrees Celsius. Wax solidifies at about minus 25 degrees Celsius. So like this, a pollutant or impurity can be removed from another substance by solidification. Next is dehumidification of air. So many applications require dehumidification of air. Okay, like we will see some applications later on also. So that dehumidification of air is also an application of refrigeration. How is that dehumidification done? Dehumidification is done by cooling the air below its dew point temperature. Okay, so what will happen? Since the air is cooled below the dew point temperature, the air will give away its moisture content and air is dehumidified. Next application is removal of heat of reaction. In many chemical reactions, efficiency is better if reaction occurs below room temperature. This requires refrigeration. If the reactions are exothermic in nature, then more refrigeration capacities are required. So one example we had seen before, like fermentation. Okay, before this slide also we had seen that example. So there we have exothermic reaction. So there refrigeration is required. So production of viscose rayon, cellular acetate, and synthetic rubber are some of the examples for removing heat of reaction. Fermentation is also one of the example. Next is storage as liquid at low pressure. Liquid occupies less space than gases. So if gas is there, if that is cooled with the help of refrigeration, it can be converted into liquid. Okay, if it is the temperature is low as well as pressure is low. So same thing is written. Most of the refrigerants are stored at high pressure. This pressure is usually their saturation pressure at atmospheric temperature. For some gases, saturation pressure at room temperature is very high. Hence, these are stored at relatively low pressure and low temperature. For example, natural gas is stored at 0.7 bar gauge pressure and minus 130 degree Celsius. So this we will be looking in detail. LNG, liquefied natural gas, and how that natural gas is liquefied. That is called liquefaction of natural gas. Okay, so basically this is also an application of refrigeration where we have gas, it is liquefied and it is stored, because what happens, the volume will reduce. Okay, vapor has larger volume and liquid has smaller volume as compared to vapor. So transportation of natural gas becomes easy in that case. Next application, in chemical and process industries of refrigeration is recovery of solvents. In many chemical processes, solvents are used which usually evaporate after reaction. These can be recovered by condensation at low temperature by refrigeration system. Some examples are acetone in film manufacture and carbon tetrachloride in textile production. So these are some of the solvents being used, okay, which evaporate after the process. Okay, now they are recovered by condensation and they can be reused. So same thing is written over here, recovery of solvents. Next we will see the previous one which we have seen over here, previous application, storage as liquid at low pressure. So we will see application of liquefied natural gas, that is LNG. So liquefaction of natural gas. Okay, so we will see this. Gas resources are plentiful and geographically diverse. So if you consider natural gas, it is available in large quantity, but it is available at very large distances. And natural gas is cleanest burning fossil fuel. So liquefied natural gas, that is LNG, is natural gas, predominantly methane, CH4, with mixture of ethane, C2H6, that has to be cooled to liquid state for shipping and storage. Reduce its bulk. What is meaning of this? A volumetric reduction 600 times or more, with corresponding reduction in scale of all storage and transport equipment. Meaning, if you consider natural gas, okay, it is in form of gas. If it is liquefied, then there is reduction of volumetric reduction of 600 times or more for storage and transportation. So that is why the natural gas is liquefied and it is stored. Liquefied natural gas is odorless, colorless, non-toxic and non-corrosive. LNG is normally warmed to make natural gas to be used in heating and cooking, as well as electricity generation and other industrial uses. So what happens, first the natural gas, it is liquefied, then it is stored, okay, then whenever time is right, whenever there is demand, it is transported to the required destination. Then again it is heated and converted to gas and then sent to the required place for the particular application, like heating is there, cooking is there, or electricity generation is there. Propane is used as a refrigerant in first loop, and compressors are multi-stage. So here you can see this is an LNG carrier. Okay, you can see the shape of this. This is a dome shape. Okay, so that it can handle the required amount of pressure, LNG pressure. This is called a LNG carrier, tanker or tank ship. Now here you can observe the process. This is the pipeline feed gas. Then there is a gas treatment where the impurities are removed in the form of condensate, like carbon dioxide, mercury, hydrogen sulfide, water. Then next we have refrigerant compressor. So the natural gas, it is liquefied and the temperature is minus 161 degrees Celsius, and then it is stored in LNG storage. Then LNG is transferred to regasification plant, where when the ship reaches the destination, a gas is transported to consumers through pipelines. So here you can observe one more diagram is given. So from gas field, natural gas is taken out, okay, then it is processed, then it is gas processing facility, there condensate is removed, CO2, water, mercury, H2S, it is removed, then the natural gas is liquefied, it is stored, then it is transported to the LNG carrier, then LNG carrier goes to the required destination, again there will be pipeline, okay, in the sea, through which the ship supplies the liquefied natural gas again to the LNG tank. Then there is regasification, and after regasification, either it can be used for power generation or it can be sent through pipeline for the cooking purpose. Next, we will see liquefaction of gases. Now, previously, what we have seen, it is liquefaction of natural gas. Okay, and that gas is called liquefied natural gas, LNG. Now, what we are looking at, it is liquefaction of gases. Okay, so this is a different topic. Okay, now this liquefaction of gases, it comes under cryogenic. Okay, so here one table has been given. Okay, we will see this table. Gas must be liquefied in order to produce low temperature for refrigeration purposes. Also, separation of oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, helium and other gases by fractional distillation. Following are the methods to convert the gases into liquefied form. Linde-Hampson system, it is also called Joule-Thomson cycle, JT cycle. Then second one is dual pressure JT cycle. And third one is Claude cycle. Okay, now in detail, if you want, you can go through ASHRAE handbook refrigeration SI units, page 47.6, where you will find all these methods in detail. Now here one table has been shown, which is taken from Linde group PDF file, cryogenic liquefied gases by Linde group. Here you can see the temperatures, boiling point. Okay, so if you consider helium, its temperature is minus 269 degrees Celsius, meaning what is the maximum, what is the lowest temperature which you can achieve? Minus 273. Okay, and with the help of helium, we can achieve minus 269 degrees Celsius. Similarly, you can see the temperature of hydrogen. Okay, boiling point of hydrogen, it is, you can compare this with the boiling point of water. What is boiling point of water at atmospheric condition? 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, and if you see the helium, liquid helium, it boils at minus 269 degrees Celsius, meaning that liquid helium, it will take up the heat from the surrounding and it will boil, and because of that, whatever refrigerating effect we are getting in the closed enclosure, it will be, the temperature there will be minus 269 degrees Celsius. Similarly, you can see the temperature of hydrogen, liquid hydrogen, it will boil at a temperature for this pressure. It will boil at minus 253 degrees Celsius. Okay, and carbon dioxide we have already seen. It boils at the solid carbon dioxide. This is at minus 78.5 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. Okay, same thing for hydrogen, you can see, for oxygen, you can see the temperature is minus 183 degrees Celsius. Okay, so these are the boiling point of different gases. Okay, so in cryogenics, here you can observe very low temperature. Cryogenic, it deals with very low temperature. Then liquefaction of gases. So we will continue with that. What is the method to actually get liquefied gas? So it was, here you can see first application of this. It was by Carl von Linde, German scientist. This was the original diagram where you can see this is written in German, but basically these are the same compressor. This is compressor. Then this is condenser. Okay. Same VCRS system is there here. Okay, you can get the translation here. You can go to Google and get the translation of this. Okay, then his machine, it was displayed in 1900 World Fair in Paris. Okay, now how this works basically? We will see that application of that. This is TH diagram, temperature versus entropy diagram. And here we have the system by which we can get liquefied air. Okay, so this is the suction of the compressor, and the compression is isothermal compression. Okay, so here there will be the suction part, and the compression is done. Usually this is multi-stage compression with intercooling. So 1 to 2 is isothermal compression. Now here you can observe 1 to 2, this is isothermal compression. Usually the pressure is 100 to 200 atmosphere, times of atmosphere. Then after compression, the air, it goes to heat exchanger. Okay, here you cannot say it is condenser, this is heat exchanger. Okay, after heat exchanger, here you can see 2 to 3. This is constant pressure heat exchanger. Okay, so there will be heat exchange between some other fluid and the temperature reduces at constant pressure. Suppose the temperature is minus 106.7 degrees Celsius. Then there is throttling, isenthalpic throttling from 3 to 4. So here you can see 3 to 4, there is throttling. Then at point number 5, liquid air is separated, and at point number 6, we have the air in gas form, and again that air, it goes to through the heat exchanger where it exchanges the heat with the 2-3 point. Okay, so here heat is exchanged, and again 0.7 it mixes with the makeup air and goes back to the suction of the compressor. So inside the heat exchanger, there is heat exchange between the compressor outlet air and air from 0.6. Okay, and finally here at this location, the air is at temperature of minus 190 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. So in this way, the air is converted into liquid air. So this is called Linde system for liquefaction of air. Similarly, there could be other systems. Okay, here you can see there are different gases. Okay, for different gases, there are different temperatures, and based on that, we can liquefy the required gas. Next, we will see some special applications of refrigeration. So, we have completed with the second part, chemical and process industries. Okay, now we will see the third application of refrigeration, that is special application of refrigeration. So first one is cold treatment of metal. The dimensions of precision parts and gauge blocks can be stabilized by soaking the product at temperature around minus 90 degrees Celsius. The hardness and wear resistance of carburized steel can be increased by this process, that is called cryogenic hardening. Keeping the cutting tool at minus 100 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes can also increase the life of cutting tool. So these are the different things related to cold treatment of metals. In deep drying process, the ductility of metal increases at low temperature. Mercury pattern. So if you consider casting, there is a type of casting which is called precision casting using mercury patterns. Okay, there also this refrigeration is required. So mercury patterns frozen by refrigeration can be used for precision casting. Next, we have medical purpose. So blood plasma antibiotics are manufactured by freeze drying process, where water is made to sublimate at low pressure and low temperature. This does not affect the tissue of the blood. Centrifuges refrigerated at minus 10 degrees Celsius are used to manufacture of drugs, used in manufacture of drugs. Localized refrigeration by liquid nitrogen can be used as anesthesia also. The next application is ice rings. Okay, what is this ice ring? We will see. Okay, so if you consider ice hockey, there the stadium, whatever the ground is there, that is called ice rink. Okay, so how that is manufactured, we will see. So the bottom, the floor, if you observe of the ice hockey ring, initially it is made up of cement or concrete. Okay, so rink floor, it is made up of concrete slab. Then methanol is used as refrigerant. And inside the ground itself, there are tubings, okay, pipelines are there inside which refrigerant is pumped. Okay, and there will be a central chilling system. Based because of that, what will happen, the refrigerant which is there inside the ground, okay, it will be chilled. So refrigerant pumped through the pipe underneath the rink floor. The concrete chills between minus 7.7 degrees Celsius to 9 degrees Celsius. So because of that, there is a vapor compression refrigeration system attached to this piping, and it basically, this bottom part is the evaporator part, okay, below the ground. So what will happen, because of that, the concrete will chill, then water is spread on the concrete, okay, on the top side of the surface, and that will freeze in seconds, forming a layer of ice. in this way, layer by layer, that rink is formed. Okay, and the ice is built in layers, each about 2 mm thick. Then ice is painted white instead of the floor, because at the end, when ice is removed, paint might chip off from the concrete. Okay, so what is done? Concrete floor is not painted white. Okay, first water is sprayed, layer by layer ice is created 2 mm, and then at certain layer white paint is sprayed. Okay, then again after that ice layer is formed. Why? Because otherwise there will be direct friction and that color will be removed. Okay, so again a layer of ice is there on the top, and the concrete itself, it is not painted white. Why? Because when ice has to be removed, at that time the color will also come out. Okay, chip off from the concrete. So this is how it works. You can see this is the bottom side of the stadium. Okay, where you can see the tubings are laid. These are the tubings. Then here the refrigerant used is glycol. Here you can see the pink material. Okay, pink liquid. This is glycol. Outside here you can see there is a portable. Okay, it can be this can be transported. This chiller. And this is 360 tons of refrigeration chiller, and it chills the glycol within 5 seconds. So this person is spraying the water on this chilled glycol, and ice is created layer by layer. Okay, then the color is sprayed and freezed, and again on the top of the color a protective layer of ice is formed. So this is the application of ice rink. Next special application of refrigeration is construction. So setting of concrete is an exothermic process. You might have already observed during the construction, when concrete is used, we require to, after the work is done, okay, we continuously pour water on the concrete. Why? Because heat is generated by the concrete, and that needs to be dissipated, otherwise cracks will be formed. Okay, so that is why after setting of the concrete, heat has to be removed. If the heat of setting is not removed, the concrete will expand and produce cracks in the structure. Concrete may be cooled by cooling sand, gravel and water before mixing them, or second is by passing the chilled water through the pipes embedded in the concrete. So what will happen, there will be the, suppose road is being manufactured, concrete road. So inside the road itself, there will be small tubing inside which water can be passed. Like similar to the ice rink. But in ice rink, what is done? The rink is formed by spraying the water. Instead of that, here what is done, inside the tubing, normal water is sent so that it can absorb the heat from the concrete. Another application is to freeze the wet soil by refrigeration to facilitate its excavation. So here you can see again, these are the metal rods. Okay, on which you can observe here tubing is being laid, and the cool water will be passing through this tube, after which the concrete is being poured. Okay, so because of that, what will happen, whatever the heat is generated, it will be taken away, it will be absorbed by this flowing water inside the tubing to cool the concrete. So dam is one of the place where this type of system is being used for cooling the concrete. Why? Because if you consider dam, lot of cement is being poured over there. Okay, so lot of heat is generated, and to prevent the expansion and cracking, we require cooling. Next application of refrigeration is desalination. Okay, so you might have heard that heating is one of the method. Like you can heat the water will evaporate, and then you can condense the water and you can get pure water. Okay. Instead of that, refrigeration can also be used to achieve the desalination of water. Okay, so that method is called freeze melting, FM, freeze melting process for desalination. In some countries, fresh water is scarce and sea water is desalinated to obtain fresh water. Solar energy is used in some cases for desalination. Okay, so this is related to either energy production and then desalinated, or using the thermal energy directly. Another alternative is what? Freezing the seawater. the ice thus formed will be relatively free of salt. The ice can be separated and thawed to obtain fresh water. Now what happens basically, if you consider this process, here diagram has been shown, saline water is there, okay, it is freezed at lower temperature. Now because of that, what will happen, saline water is what, basically it is brine, okay. So after freezing, what will happen, whatever pure water is there, it will freeze first, okay, and brine will not freeze. Why? Because the freezing point of brine, it is much less, okay. So whatever the ice crystals are formed, they are basically of pure water. So then concentrated water, that is the brine, it is removed, then ice, it is washed, it is cleaned, and then it is heated. To melt the ice, ice is melted by heating and we get pure water. This is called freeze melting process. Now this type of process, it can be done easily where already the atmosphere is cool. Like if you consider North Pole and South Pole, there this process is very easy. Why? Because directly surrounding itself is very cool. Okay, so ice formation is very easy there. Okay, otherwise hectic process like compressors are required to actually freeze the saline water. Okay, which will be very, here the power consumption will be more. But if you consider the places where naturally the temperature is less, in that case this freeze melting process is very easy. So the disadvantage of this freeze melting process for desalination is retention of undesirable flavors and aromas, because whatever water is there, same water we are converting to ice, and then again that ice is converted to water. So whatever undesirable flavor and aroma is there, that will stay with water. Okay, so that is the disadvantage of this freeze melting process. Next, special application of refrigeration is manufacturing of ice. Okay, so this is related to ice plant. And next one is cold chain, which is a system of storing and transporting vaccines. So this again itself, it is a very big topic, cold chain. Okay, so we will see commercial ice plant or ice making process. So this we have already discussed, so I won't be going in detail. Okay, in brief, I will be explaining this. We have a vapor compression refrigeration system, okay, where we have components like compressor, then evaporative condenser, receiver is there, expansion is there, expansion valve, and then evaporator. So in ice plant, primary refrigerant is ammonia and secondary refrigerant is brine. So in this system, vapor compression refrigeration system, we have ammonia as primary refrigerant, whereas you can see this portion, brine tank, there we will have brine as secondary refrigerant. So there will be compression, low pressure, low temperature ammonia vapor enters the compressor. It will be compressed to high pressure, high temperature. Then after that, there will be an oil separator. So oil is separated in the oil separator and again it is sent back to the compressor. Then high pressure, high temperature vapor ammonia, it is sent to the evaporative condenser. In evaporative condenser, both water and air is used to condense the high pressure, high temperature ammonia vapor. So at the exit of the evaporative condenser, we will have high pressure, medium temperature ammonia liquid, it goes to the liquid receiver. Then according to the need, the liquid ammonia, it is sent to the expansion valve, where expansion will occur, and because of that there will be pressure drop and temperature drop. It goes to the evaporator. Okay, so evaporator, it is there basically in the below the wooden lid itself, where there will be tubing. Okay, and so inside the tubing, basically ammonia will be there, and then again the after that there will be suction accumulator, and the vapor ammonia, only vapor ammonia, it will go back to the compressor. So accumulator makes sure that only the vapor ammonia goes back to the compressor, otherwise the reciprocating compressor, it will get damaged. Okay, now the inside the evaporator, what is there, brine is there. Okay, and that brine, it is being chilled with the help of ammonia. Okay, so this chilled brine, it goes to the brine tank, and inside the brine tank there are ice cans. okay, inside the ice can water is there. Now, since the brine is at lower temperature, it will pick up the heat from the water. So basically, water gives its heat to brine, and brine gives its heat to ammonia. And ammonia finally rejects its heat to atmosphere, okay, to water and atmosphere. Then the ice is formed over here, and using the crane, EOT crane, this ice can is removed, and ice is removed and it is stored in the cold storage and transported according to the use, according to the demand. So here you can observe on the top side wooden leads are there above the brine tank. Why we are using wooden leads? To provide insulation and facilitate easy removal of the top lead so that the ice can be removed easily. Usually it takes about 24 hours to manufacture this ice from water. And also here you can see agitator is there. Agitator is used to enhance the heat transfer rate between the, it is always advisable that brine should be in motion. If brine is stagnant, then what will happen? There will not be proper heat transfer. Okay, so that is why agitator is provided, so that there is a constant motion of brine and it will reject the heat to the ammonia because of this agitator. Okay, actually this evaporator part, it is there inside this this tank itself. Okay, there is a separate compartment over here where this evaporator is there and agitator is there in that section, and it agitates the brine over this evaporator coil, and inside the tubing what is present? Ammonia is present. That ammonia, it will absorb the heat from the brine, and then that brine, it is discharged in this tank so that it can absorb the heat from the water inside the ice can. Now here you can observe the shape of the ice can. It is trapezoidal for easy removal of ice. So primary refrigerant is ammonia, secondary refrigerant is brine. Brine is agitated continuously for increasing the heat transfer from water in the can to the chilled brine. The brine solution is kept at constant motion by agitators. Now this we have already seen before as well. In case of refrigerants, you can refer that video. In refrigerant, what is the amount of salt that should be added to the water? Okay, it depends on what the eutectic condition, okay, eutectic temperature. We have seen the eutectic temperature of NaCl and CaCl, okay, calcium chloride and sodium chloride. You can connect that with this one. Okay, you have to make the you have to basically connect what you have studied before with this one. Okay, ice cans are made of trapezoidal shape, and these are usually galvanized steel sheet to prevent corrosion. Next application we will see, cold chain. Now this is very important application. Right now also you can see in COVID 19 pandemic, okay, whatever cold chain is there, that is very important. So what is this cold chain? Cold chain is a system of storing and transporting vaccines at recommended temperatures from the point of manufacture to point of use. So here we have vaccine manufacturer. Okay, it can be transported with the help of aircraft or any other method. It goes to primary storage. Then using refrigerated van, it is taken to state storage. So from one state, suppose the vaccine is being manufactured at Serum Institute of India in Pune. It is transferred using aircraft to some other state in primary storage. Then using the refrigerated insulated van, it is taken to the state storage. Then insulated van is again used to transport it to the district vaccine storage. Then from there, it is again transported using refrigerated van to primary healthcare center. Then from there, we have a small vaccine box is there, which people carry to the substation, and from there the people are vaccinated. So this process you can observe here, complete refrigeration is required. Okay, there are different temperatures for different type of vaccines. Okay, so what are the different cold chain equipments for storage purpose? We have in case of electrical, walk-in cooler, where you can walk inside directly inside the cooler. There are very big coolers. The next one is walk-in freezers, WIF. Then next one is ice lined refrigerator, very important. If you consider vaccine storage, this ice lined refrigerator is very important. We will see this in detail. Ice lined refrigerator. Next one is defreezer. Then in storage itself, the second application is solar, where we have solar refrigerator. Third one is non-electrical application, where we have cold box or vaccine carrier. This also we will see in detail. Then after that, we have transportation using refrigerated van, insulated van, cold box, vaccine carrier or ice pack. Then with the if you consider this ice line refrigerator or deep freezer, along with that stabilizer, generator and inverter is also required. Because what will happen in many places, it is possible that electricity is not available. So if electricity, there is if suppose there is power failure and electricity is not there, the temperature will drop and vaccines will be spoiled. To prevent that, always stabilizer, generator and inverters are provided along with this ice line refrigerator. Okay, this is mandatory requirement. So if you want to store vaccine, if you are in future, if you are thinking to go into the business of this storage of vaccine, if you are purchasing ice line refrigerator, along with that, you need to purchase these equipments as well. Then there are temperature monitoring devices like thermometer and etc. for data logging. Okay, data logger is also used to actually log the data, and we can find from there where exactly things went wrong. Okay, to monitor that, we have data logger as well. Okay, next we will see ice line refrigerator. So this is the peak of ice line refrigerator, which is used for vaccine storage. Now why this is called ice line refrigerator? Because the wall of this refrigerator, it is lined with water, and when this refrigerator is turned on, it gets converted into ice. Now what is the advantage of this? Suppose there is power failure, so hold over time it can be increased. Okay, so same thing is written, hold over time for an ice lined refrigerator is minimum 20 hours at 43 degrees Celsius, as it has ice lining inside its wall. Okay, now when you consider this ice lined refrigerator, here you can see in this pic the right sequence of different vaccines is given over here. On the bottom side we have OPV, then measles, then TT, and on the top side we have hepatitis B. Okay, in this way only the vaccine should be stored inside the ice lined refrigerator, because proper temperature should be maintained. Okay, and here you can observe these blue color boxes. Okay, this blue color lid, inside this the vaccine is stored. Now this, you can see this arrangement, it is top opening arrangement. Okay, why top opening arrangement is important over here? Because an ice lined refrigerator with top opening lid prevents loss of cold air during the door opening. Because you know that cold air, it is having larger density as compared to hot air. So cold air, it will remain on the bottom side. Okay, so when you open the lid on the top side, the heat exchange, okay, it will be less as compared to front opening refrigerator. That is why here you can observe this opening, it is on, there on the top side. So an ILR with top opening lid prevents loss of cold air during door opening and can keep vaccine safe with as little as 8 hours electricity supply in 24 hours period. Now this is possible, why? Because of this ice lined condition. Okay, then there is lining of water containers, that is called ice packs, fitted all around the wall and held in place by frame. An ice lined refrigerator maintains a cabinet temperature between +2 and +8 degrees Celsius. Now this is for +2 to +8 degrees Celsius. There are few vaccines which require negative temperature, so those vaccines can be stored in deep freezer. It is used to store universal immunization program UIP vaccines at primary health care PHC and district levels. Next is cold box and ice packs. This box, blue color box, this you can see, this is called cold box. This is used for transportation of vaccines, and inside this cold box, this is usually insulated, and inside this ice packs are kept. Okay, here you can observe this plastic box is there, and inside this box, eutectic fluid is filled. Okay, whose it is also called antifreeze fluid. This ice pack, it is basically kept in deep freezer. Okay, and it is chilled, and then it is transferred to this cold box to maintain the temperature inside the cold box. So a cold box is an insulated box. This box is insulated, used for transportation and emergency use, emergency storage of vaccines and ice packs. So this box, inside this, it is kept cool with the help of this ice pack. Ice packs are plastic containers filled with water. It can be filled with water or it can be filled with antifreeze liquid. Okay, these are hard frozen in deep freezer. So this ice pack, it is kept where? In the deep freezer. These are placed inside the vaccine carrier and cold box to improve and maintain the holdover time. They are also used in ice-lined refrigerator as inside lining to improve and maintain holdover time during electricity failure. Next is deep freezer. Okay, so again, deep freezer, you can see this is top opening type deep freezer, or we can even have front door type deep freezer. The cabinet temperature, inside temperature maintained is between minus 18 and minus 20 degrees Celsius. Ice packs, which we have seen in previous case here, this ice pack are hard frozen in deep freezer in cold chain. Next, these are called walk-in coolers or walk-in freezers. Okay, so person, he can walk inside this one and store the required vaccine inside the walk-in cooler. Walk-in cooler are used for bulk storage at state and regional stores. Typically, the temperature is between plus 2 to plus 8 degrees Celsius. It stores 3 months of requirement of vaccine plus 25% buffer stock. Then next, this we are talking about cold chain. Okay, continuously whatever we are talking, it is related to cold chain for vaccines. So here you can see next one is reefer. Basically, reefer is what? It is refrigerated container. So this type of reefer, it can be either be used to transport the required material by either ships or vehicles. Previously, if you recall, in the evaporator module, okay, where we have studied vapor compression refrigeration system, in evaporators, we have seen this plate surface serpentine tube type evaporator, where we have top sheet metal, bottom sheet metal, and inside this we have a refrigerant tube inside which refrigerant flows, and in between the gap, in between the two sheets, eutectic solution is being filled. So what will happen? This refrigerant, it will chill the eutectic solution and it will increase the holdover time. Okay, so solution, this eutectic solution here you can observe. This is eutectic solution, and inside these tubes, refrigerant flows. Okay, now what is done? Here you can observe these are the eutectic plates. Inside this, there will be tubes like this, and this tube, it is connected to refrigeration system. So here you can observe this is the internal portion of a refrigerated truck, and these are the eutectic plates. Here you can observe eutectic plates. These are installed inside surface of the truck or inside surface of the vehicle. And here you can see the copper tubings are there. It comes outside. Basically, what is done? There will be a land-based refrigeration system either, or it could be in the vehicle as well. And that land-based system, it will chill this eutectic solution which is there inside the plate. And once the vehicle is on the move, that ground-based system is disconnected and vehicle can transport the inside product in the refrigerated state. Why? Because the eutectic solution is cool. Okay, so it will provide the constant refrigeration inside the vehicle. Okay, inside whatever products are kept, it will provide the refrigeration. This again, you have to make the connection with previous thing which we have studied. Okay, plate surface serpentine tube type evaporator. Okay, next we have completed with the application of refrigeration. Okay, now we will start with application of air conditioning.